already heating up. Heating up, the bearing becoming expand, that's why it is very easy to ease up to the shaft. Not necessary too much heating. Anyway, we have completed both sides, drive and no drive temperature. And then we are cleaning up all oil. And then assemble the rotor to the upper coil. Begin the... Both sides of the rotor are cleaning and ready for install. So we have put the marking, so putting the same place of the marking. Apply a little bit of grease to the bowl. Check the marking. Then I put on the bowl. So after it is getting the temperature right, so we will install the hopper. After installing the coupling, then tighten the lock. Don't forget to tighten the lock, otherwise the foam will move in. Yeah. Also, we are setting back the foam plane as previously. The position is same, trying to support the motor. Before using the fluke insulation tester, we have to make sure that this fluke insulation tester is in good condition by testing on the body. So if it is indicator 0, it means that this insulation tester is in good condition. And next we will test the over then 550, over then 550 mega ohm is good. Next, over then 550 mega ohm is good. So stock still good condition. Bearing replacement has been done. The motor will be boxed up, and the remaining is the install to local site to the pump.
Before installing the motor to the pump, clean the motor seating and check the condition of the rubber coupling. Install all the connection and cabling as per the previous marking. After completion of the motor installation to the pump, then take out the tugout and lockout notice. Open the padlock and confirm that the correct power panel to be breaker on the power source. Check all the valve position is under standby position before dry running of the pump. At first, carry out start and stop or pitching start for the pump in order to check the motor rotation is correct and to confirm that the load of the motor is normal. When all confirmed under normal condition, then start the motor from control room and keep running to check the performance of newly replaced motor bearing. Check the pressure and ampere of the motor, then check the motor sound and its vibration. As you can see, the current measurement of vibration is in good condition. Also, the ampere meter showing normal value. I think that's all the sharing of the motor bearing replacement. Thank you for watching my video. If you have any advice, suggestion, and question, please let me know. Please leave at the comment below. If you consider that this video beneficially, please click like and subscribe button and don't forget to share to others. Bye, the Antonio Project.